Why, hello. So, it's Saturday the 21st. Feeling a bit excited right now. Just feeling a little bit excited. You know, Christmas is soon. Okay, so I know what you're thinking. You're like, Christmas is coming up. What was it I had to do? Oh yeah. What do I buy for presents? Never fear. I'm here to help. So basically this video, if you hadn't gathered by the title, is just some ideas of what you can buy your friends for Christmas. Christmas. I don't know what accent that was. Christmas. I'm gonna try and give away some ideas so that I don't give away any Christmas presents that I've got for my friends, just in case I haven't given them to them yet. So, because Christmas is the time of year for me where it's summer, you can't really go around and giving those nice Christmas sweaters and everything like that. Because as much as I'd love to, because I'd buy everyone a Christmas sweater every year if I could, it just doesn't suit the climate that Australia has. Around the 25th of December, it's like 40 degrees, so you literally don't go outside all day on Christmas. That's why most people gain a lot of weight on Christmas, because they eat a lot and then they don't go outside. Really? Present idea number one. Candles. Candles are a beautiful present to give to friends or relatives, because they're just like a simple thing. You can buy scents, you can buy colors, you can buy shapes, you can buy sizes, many different things with candles, which can just describe a lot to the person about what you wanted. Like, I saw the other day in the shops, there was like a love one, or there was a hope one, and everything like that, or a thank you. Like, you can buy candles that mean so many things, and there's beautiful ones that you can buy with a little, or you can buy little tea lights with a little special way to sit in it. I don't know what that thing is. So that's a really good present. Present idea number two. These days I found that a lot of people like soaps and stuff from like The Body Shop or Lush. I find that those two shops will probably find a lot of people's presents for people, as these have a wide range of different scents, different colors, and I can guarantee you either of these shops will have a scent and a color for the friend or family member that you're buying for. Idea number three. Okay, so if you're going for a more personalized gift, maybe it's for someone you're in love with, or just a really close family member that you really appreciate, you can get them a nice piece of jewelry from a jewelry shop. Say, like, for an early Christmas present, early Christmas present for my one of my relatives in England when I went in September, they got me this little necklace that was a moon and a star. I found this was really cute, and I think it's just a really nice token of how much you appreciate them and how much you just wanted to show how much the season means to you and like how much they mean to you at the same time. So yeah, idea number four. It could be simple, like chocolates. Everybody loves chocolate, except if they're allergic to them. So you should check if they're allergic to anything before you buy them chocolates. But most of the time, everybody loves chocolates. So I don't think you can ever go wrong if you buy someone chocolates, because chocolates are chocolates. And I don't know, either you can buy different shapes. I mean, Lindor like makes teddy bears or reindeers. I don't even know if they make the reindeers anymore. But I know Lindor makes teddy bears, and then they make boxes like that look like reefs. This year they made the box that looks like a reef that had little round chocolates in them. And I just think it's a beautiful gift for someone. So, you know. Present idea number five. I think it's number five. I've lost count. I don't even know. If it's someone you're really close to and you know like what they have and what they don't have, you could buy them like a nice Christmas ornament or yeah, a nice Christmas ornament. You can, most of the time these days there's so many Christmas ornaments out there that you couldn't possibly go wrong by getting them a Christmas ornament. And they will absolutely like, most of the time people are always looking for another Christmas ornament, even if they have a lot of Christmas ornaments. Everybody understands that they can never go wrong with another Christmas ornament, because ornaments are just like something you require and want at the same time. So I don't know, I just feel like people love Christmas ornaments. Number six. Sorry. Number six could be a handmade gift. My mum made me these little hearts with different coloured outsides based on Christmas colours, which I gave to my friends as a pre-Christmas present this year. Which made it something special. I mean, it's obviously different from what you're going to find in the shops, and it's going to be something special because it means something more to you. Ideally make it yourself, but I'm lazy and I couldn't be bothered. No, I just can't crochet. Crochet is just makes me frustrating. But I'm not going to tell you my life story because you don't want to know that. Number seven. Okay, so your friend, she's been hinting to you, he or she has been hinting to you for a while, that they really wanted this shirt that that they don't have the money for. Basically, or like clothing item or perfume. And if you're like a dear friend that you are, and you're like, well, I don't know what else to get them, so maybe I'll get them this. And if they're really close to you, I suggest you don't buy something really expensive if they're not that close to you. It's like, if they're your friend, your best friend's friend, then, and you went shopping with them with your best friend, then just don't buy them the expensive thing, because I can guarantee you that they'll just keep doing the same thing. Anyways, but if they're really dear to you and you know that they really want it for such a long time, you can get them the special thing that they want and they will feel happy about it, and it just makes the festive season a little bit more brighter for them, you know? Because they just feel a bit happy and stuff. Number eight. Okay, so your friend, she really likes this band, right? Or this artist, and you know they're coming to town around Christmas or even after Christmas, and you're like, you really want to go with her, but you're not too sure if she's going to buy tickets, and she doesn't even know that they're coming. So you could be like, well, let's buy a ticket. That could be a really nice Christmas present for someone, because it's like, if they mean this band or artist means so much to them, it'll just change their life and stuff like that, because they feel like they I don't know, I just, they probably love you on another level, so. Number nine. Okay, that was really weird. Number nine. So, I know there's charities out there, there's like these orphanage charities and stuff like that, where you can buy them animals that helps their family and stuff like that. And most of the time, and sometimes people buy those things and give them to other people and be like, you know what, like, we've helped someone. And sure, it's not like a massive thing that people would like be able to keep. It's something that you know that you've helped change someone's life this festive season. And that can be a gift to someone in another country. And although this isn't giving it to someone else, it could be, it helps people, you know, and it makes the festive season just that much better, because the festive season for me, it's about coming together as a family and helping to better understand each other. Like, it's not about the presents, it's about being together. And I think to help other people in less fortunate countries, you need to go and like help them by sponsoring a child, or even buying this. There's this charity, remember, there's like sending animals or like giving them money to buy animals in their country, which helps their families come home for Christmas and eat for Christmas and stuff like that, which is a plus for these people. So yeah, that's a nice gift for people who are fortunate. And finally, number 10, the gift of joy and happiness. This may be because you completely just don't have any money, or you yourself as a teenager or something like that, you don't have any money, or you just really don't think any of these other gifts would really work for this person, and they're part of your family and you know that they won't be expecting it. You can just like surprise them by coming to them on Christmas and saying Merry Christmas, I hope this is special. And I know just these little things like that can make somebody so happy. And so I reckon that's a good Christmas present. It doesn't need money, it just needs love. So, and I'm a sucker for love, so I'm sorry if this turned into some mushy goodness and you're like, what are you doing? Anyways guys, I just love Christmas and I thought I'd give you some ideas, as Christmas is soon, and I thought I'd give you some ideas about what you could buy for your friends or family just to make this festive season a little bit brighter and a little bit easier for some people who are struggling to find ideas. So yeah, I hope you have a lovely day. I'll see you tomorrow for my Why I Love Christmas. Peace, love, fuck shit up. I'm dying right now. Festive season a little bit. Collarbone showing there. Honestly, what is this? Number 8 could be a mother and child. Now I'm struggling for ideas myself. You are on another level. Lever? Yes.